Hey everybody, what's going on? Hell Knight here, bringing you another video from Grab the Lantern today. Today I wanted to talk about the concept of one-sided stomps one way or another, and kind of seeing if we can verify if that's a real thing that's happening currently in League of Legends, or if it's just a lot to do with perception. Because it seems to be this current iteration or expectation of players currently that games are always one-sided stomps. If you win super duper hard. If you lose, you have lost incredibly hard. You didn't have a chance. Basically, either your team went 20-0 or their team went 0-20 or whatever. It's never, people have this conception that it's never a balanced game either way. And I don't quite know that I buy this for a couple of different reasons, and I kind of wanted to unpack that today. Now, first and foremost, I do think that, yes, there are definitely a lot of one-sided games that can happen, but generally, very rarely is it because one team is just feeding outright. I think that a lot of it is because you, as I mentioned before in kind of my the video where I talk about the current meta and why it sort of exists, and damage creep, a lot of the champions being played nowadays are very high damage champions with very little defense. So essentially, the problem that we run into is that you're in a situation where you have a lot of champions that can run away with a lead, but conversely do very little if they fall behind. Talon is a good poster boy of this, Zed as well, where they're champions where if they don't get ahead, or even worse, if they fall very far behind, they're not actually going to do anything. Unfortunately, they just don't have the utility or anything else they can do with themselves besides damage, which means that if a Talon falls behind, what is he supposed to do? The only thing he knows how to do is go on the enemy AD carry and try to burst them, but if he can't burst them, he doesn't have anything else he can contribute to the team. He can't kill the marksman. He's essentially dead weight to his team from that point onwards. And that's a lot of the champions that are being played in the current meta because people are still kind of adjusting to the return to League of Legends, to the buffs that have gone through for tanks and crit marksmen. A lot of those things, you're still seeing a lot of high damage champions being played all the time, especially high damage champions with very low utility. And this ends up in a situation where, yeah, if you fall behind as someone like Talon, there's not an awful lot you can do. And that does kind of lead to a stomp, because if you fall behind as Talon, you have essentially no way to get back in the game, so to speak. You have no recourse of action. And Orianna, for example, can at the very least use her utility. She has her ultimate. She has her ability to land a good shockwave. She can shield her friends. Even if it's not for a lot, she can shield them. Orianna has things she can do if she's behind, whereas a lot of these other champions don't have that, and that leads to them dying again and again and again as they try desperately to do something to help their team, and unfortunately they don't have that opportunity. So I think that's the biggest thing why people feel like games are one-sided, because yeah, I was playing Yasuo, or even if you weren't the one playing the champion, if your top lane Yasuo falls behind early, well, what else is he supposed to do? He's going to dash around a lot, he's not going to do a lot of damage, and he's probably still going to die. Maybe he windwalled something, maybe he didn't, but suffice it to say, he's probably going 0-10 at that point. It's just very volatile champions being played, and that leads to a snowbally-esque environment. And so, obviously, this is pretty easily fixed if you are the one who plays these kinds of champions, which is to understand that, yeah, these champions are on a knife's edge. If you get ahead with them, you're going to be great, you're going to be in an excellent spot going forward. If you start falling behind, though, you may end up having some difficulties with the rest of the game because you just don't have the utility to offer the rest of your team. The other thing to consider is also the fact that, and this is just sort of a general human psychology thing, is that we tend to remember the times we do very poorly rather than the times we do very well. So if we have a game in which your team does go 0-20, you are a lot more likely to remember that and to use that as your example for, wow, every game is a stomp nowadays, even if that was the last game you played and you haven't had a one-sided stomp like that in all of the rest of your games. Players also tend to not recognize when they do the games where they do incredibly well or where it's a one-sided stomp on their own end. Usually they don't consider to be a huge stomp where they're like, wow, we just demolished the enemy team. Instead, it's usually written off, at least mentally, as, wow, I did really, really well. I had a great game and we won that game. And not as even remotely close to an example of, wow, the game is super one-sided recently and we just absolutely stomped them. So it kind of lends to a situation where you have the perception that games are a lot more one-sided without really considering the fact that some of the games you might have played recently weren't one-sided at all and were, in fact, really close. In fact, the game on screen right now is one where we did win, but it was not a stomp. And I would hesitate to say that a lot of the games I played recently have been in a similar boat. I would actually probably imply that most of the games I've played have been relatively even and gone back and forth. part of the issue as well, I think, is the perception, the go next mentality that a lot of players have, which is to say that things go poorly for the team early on. Maybe you have one solo lane feeding, maybe both of them aren't doing too well, you're not doing so hot in your own lane, and for a lot of players, sometimes they have the mentality of, well, I don't really care, go to the next game, right? Just surrender this one at 20, this game doesn't matter, we're just going to go ahead and play the next one because this one is clearly a loss. And a lot of times, I think players are writing off games that could potentially be come back from. Now, I have made a video previously about how to sort of judge as to whether or not a game can be come back from, but to briefly paraphrase that entire video, basically you want to be looking at your team's prospects in the late game and whether or not you have the ability to stop the bleeding and to try to scale up to late. Because I know I've talked about this before, but you are always better served trying to scale late and trying to wait for an opportunity for the gold to even out. And a lot of times players aren't willing to give it that level of time. A lot of times the expectation is just, well, this game is already done, so I just want to surrender it and go on to the next one, when it's a game that you very easily could have stalled out. If you're looking at a game where you're behind and saying, well, we have a lot of really good wave clear, we have a tank who needs time to scale and is going to be good late, we have a marksman who's going to need time to scale but it's going to be good late. If you have the pieces to essentially put together a solid late game performance, then it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me to say, well, just go to the next game, it doesn't matter, right? Because you do have the opportunity to come back from that. Now, if the enemy team, for example, has a 8-2 Zed who's annihilating everybody in one combo, for example, or if you happen to be already down an inhibitor at, let's say, 20 minutes into the game, then it might be worth the opinion, because that's a very difficult situation to come back from, and it may be worth it to just say, you know what, we could come back from this, but it's going to require way too much work. But a lot of times, I think people have the mentality where, I'm not doing super well in lane, I can't kill my lane opponent anymore, go next. And that does lead to kind of snowballing games, because if you've already mentally checked out of a game, of course you're going to lose it. You're not focusing anymore. You're not really trying to win the game. And if you're not trying to win the game, you're not going to play like you can win the game. You're going to play to not lose. And anyone who plays to not lose a game will invariably lose the game anyways. So I think in general, to sum all of the things I just talked about, I don't think that games are really that snowbally or that every win or loss is a one-sided stomp. I think there are a lot more close games than players are realizing that they're actually having. And I think that in general, there's a lot of just the general go-next mentality is not helping anybody find these games where they can come back from, where they can play it late. I think a lot of players are more likely to just say, just play a new one, and in the hopes that it's going to be better than the last one. And I don't know that's necessarily a good mentality to have, a good perspective to have, and I think that it's definitely not what you should be looking for if you're playing this game. I think that there are a lot more games that you can come back from, and a lot fewer games that are just completely one-sided if you just know where to look. Anyways, that's just my opinion. Go ahead and let me know what you guys are thinking of all of this, especially if you have a match history that's entirely 20-0 and 0-20. Let me know down in the comment section. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts. If you enjoyed today's video, go ahead and leave a like. And if you really enjoyed today's video, consider subscribing. I upload a video every Monday, Friday, and on patch days as well. And if you're looking for Grab the Lantern content, you can check out my blog, which is linked down in the description. I upload an article just about each and every single day for your enjoyment. Once again, thank you guys so very much for watching. I do appreciate it. And I'll talk to you all later.